system. So the control of this type of motor is quite cheap, because if you are going to incorporate a feedback system, in, for example, in case of servo motors or other type of motors, then that will be making the system costly because of incorporating sensors and other arrangements to acquire the data. Yet they provide very precise output. They're used for accurate, repeatable positioning, such as machine tool applications, robotics, plotters, and they are commonly found in printers. And the other benefits include low cost, ruggedness, and high reliability. In order to identify the stepper motor, if you have one, then it can be identified by its four or more leads. And on twisting its shaft, you can feel the clicks at each step. There's a note that if a motor have three terminals, then it is a servo motor. Well, one of the important applications that we see in day-to-day life is in printers. So in printers, the precise turn and stop nature of a stepper motor makes it ideal for pushing a piece of paper exactly one line forward. So you all see this in printouts. The gaps between any two consecutive lines are exactly equal. This is possible because of installed stepper motor operating in steps. So here we discuss about the principle of the operation of stepper motors. And later on we'll be talking about the types of stepper motors, but essentially the principle of operation for all the types of the stepper motor is same. That is, when the coil are energized, they produce magnetic poles in the stator, and the rotor will align in accordance with the direction of the magnetic field developed in the stator. And as soon as you reverse the phase of the current in the coils, in the stator coils, or if you energize only some of the coils, the alignment of stator magnetic field can take one of a discrete number of positions. But if the currents in the coils are pulsed in the appropriate sequence, the rotor will advance in a step-by-step fashion. Thus, stepper motors can be very useful whenever precise incremental motion must be attained. So they are usually operated by giving a train of pulses to the motor windings, which is shown by the illustration below. And this causes the magnetic field to rotate in steps at a speed that is based on the frequency of input pulses. So if the supply input pulses are more, if the frequency of input pulses are large, in that case, the field that will be produced, the rotating field that will be produced inside will be having a large speed. So the rotation, the magnetic field that rotates inside the stator depends upon the frequency at which the input pulses are given to the stator windings. While during the magnetic field rotates in the air gap, the rotor keeps aligning itself along the axis of rotating field that is in synchronism with the field. So shown over here is a four pole stepper motor with windings AA dash and BB dash. So when positive pulse or current is applied to the coils A and A dash, making A north magnetic pole while A dash a south magnetic pole, and this aligns the rotor along AA dash. And moreover, as long as power is applied to coil A, the rotor is held in this position. Now when the coils B and B dash are energized, it will allow the rotor to rotate by an angle of 90 degree with the condition that A and A dash are not energized. While in case A and A dash together with B and B dash are energized, in that case the rotor will take a position which will be somewhere in between the two stator poles. So it will be making approximately 45 degrees from the vertical or horizontal axis. Now the operation of this type of motor requires a controller. So it could be a DSP controller, for example LF2407, or a microcontroller like PIC microcontrollers. So a controller applies pulses to the stator windings in a manner to create a rotating field. The motor shaft rotates in either direction in multiples of the step angle by controlling the rate using the electronic controller, at which electric pulses are applied to the stepper motor windings. And the step angle is determined by the number of stator poles. So the step angle will be discussed somewhere later in this lecture. Angle of rotation, which is cumulative of motor, is directly proportional to the number of input pulses. So one benefit that the stepper motor possesses is that it bears a self-holding capability, which allows rotor to be held in the stopped position without the use of brakes. Moreover, a wide range of rotating speed proportional to the frequency of the pulse signal may be attained. So this is done by controlling the rate at which pulses are applied to the windings of the stepper motor. The speed can be varied continuously from a steady position to a maximum that depends on the motor and load. Now we talk about types. There are several types of stepper motors. The three main classifications are variable reluctance stepper motor, also known as reactive rotor, permanent magnet stepper motor called as active rotor, and hybrid stepper motor. So we'll be learning about each of these three types. So just like in any ordinary motor, the stepper motor has stator and rotor. The rotor shown over here is that of a variable reluctance type. The stator accompanies laminated poles similar to AC motors. Though AC supply is not given to windings provided on it, yet the reason for laminating stator core is that the supply pulse to the winding alternate. And if the frequency of this alternation is high, it will result in eddy current losses. So one type of stepper motor is the variable reluctance stepper motor, in short termed as VRSM. In fact, this is the same motor discussed in reluctance motor in the lecture related to reluctance motor, since it works as a reluctance motor and in steps. So it consists of a soft iron multi-tooth rotor and a wound stator. On energizing the stator winding, its poles get energized. Rotation takes place because rotor teeth following low reluctance path gets attracted to the rotating field. The variable reluctance stepper motor stator usually has 3 phases but can go to 7 phases. And the working of this type can be understood from the figure. So if the pulse is given to windings A and A dash, the rotor moves to shorten the air gap with poles A and A dash. However, if pulse is removed from A and applied to B, the rotor moves 15 degree clockwise so that 2 is aligned with B. Then if power is removed from B and applied to C, the shaft rotates further 15 degree clockwise, thus applying pulses to the coils in the sequence A, B, C, D, A, B, C and so on, results in clockwise rotation of the shaft in 15 degree increments. While if in case the switching sequence is reversed to A, D, C, B, A, so the direction of rotation will be reversed and the variable reluctance stepper motor can be single stack type or multiple stack type. Multiple stack provides smaller step sizes. And the principle of operation of VRSM has also been discussed already in the previous lecture of reluctance motor. That is, whenever the rotor is offset from its equilibrium position or low energy state, it experiences torque that aligns it back to the equilibrium position. The second type of stepper motor is the permanent magnet stepper motor, in short termed as PMSM. So in this type of motor, the stator is similar to that of reluctance motor. It has a permanent magnet cylindrical rotor called tin can rotor, with north and south poles alternating around its circumference parallel to rotor shaft, so as shown in this figure. So these are the alternating north and south poles. This is the shaft. If we talk about the working of PMSM, as in the reluctance type, the rotor position is set by applying a sequence of pulses to the stator windings. The magnetized rotor poles provide an increased magnetic flux intensity, and because of this the permanent magnet motor exhibits improved torque characteristics compared with the variable reluctance type. The PMSM permits a non-zero holding torque even when the motor is not energized. It has high inertia than variable reluctance type, thus slow acceleration. Benefits is that it is a low cost and low resolution type motor with typical step angles of 7.5 degree to 15 degrees. The third type of stepper motor is the hybrid stepper motor. So it uses both the variable reluctance and permanent magnet principles and is characterized by multitude stator and rotor as shown in figure. So this part is the rotor on the left side, and right side is the illustration of the same. And this is the stator. While these highlighted things are the teeth on the stator as well as rotor. And on the far right is the magnified version of the teeth of stator and rotor. Further, the rotor have axially magnetized concentric magnet around its shaft and ferromagnetic teeth at the outer section. So this can be seen from the figure in the middle. Two VR stacks are present, which are rotated by half a tooth pitch and separated by an axial permanent magnet. So these are the two stacks. And as you can see, these two stacks are shifted half a tooth pitch. They encapsulate a permanent magnet placed axially. Thus you can see this side as north and this one as south. Thus, while variable reluctance effect is taken into account radially, the permanent magnet effect works axially. The advantages are it has better performance with respect to step resolution, torque and speed. And this type generally has high accuracy and high holding torque and dynamic torque compared to both the variable reluctance and permanent magnet types. It can be configured to provide a step angle as small as 0.9 degrees to 3.6 degrees. Now we talk about the stepping modes. The drive modes of a stepper motor can be classified as wave, full step, half step and micro stepping drives. In case of the wave drive, only one winding is energized at any given time. The stator is energized according to the sequence A, then B, then A dash, then B dash, and the rotor steps from position A to 2 to 4 to 6. While in case of full step drive, two phases are energized at any given time. The sequence followed is A B, then A dash B, then A dash B dash, and then followed by A B dash. And the rotor steps from position 1 to 3 to 5 to 7. So this can be understood by given animations. The third type is the half step drive, which combines both wave and full step, that is switching between one and two phases drive modes. So during every second step only one phase is energized, and during the other steps one phase on each stator is energized. The stator is energized according to the sequence AB, then B only, then A dash B, then A dash only, followed by A dash B dash, then B dash, then A B dash and A. And the rotor steps from position 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5, then 6, then 7, then 8. And finally, in micro stepping drive, the currents in the windings are continuously varying. That is, it breaks up one full step in many smaller discrete steps. So this can be understood by the waveform given as input to the motor windings. So they are given in the form of a step, discrete steps, with many levels. So this resembles a sinusoid waveform. Now the step angle, angular displacement, angular speed of stepper motors. So the angle through which the motor turns for each pulse is known as step angle. This is generally expressed in degrees. So the step angle corresponding to each input pulse is given as 360 divided by rotor teeth multiplied by stator phase. If n is the number of drive pulses which are supplied to the motor, the angle through which shaft gets turned is, so the angular displacement will be given as n times the number of drive pulses times the step angle. But if the motor moves capital N steps per second, then the angular speed of motor will be equal to capital N multiplied by step angle. Now shown over here is the characteristic of stepper motor. So we define few terms here like holding torque. So this is the torque that exists when motor is powered. Then pull-in torque is the maximum torque against which a motor will start for a given pulse rate and reach synchronism without losing a step. Then pull-out torque is the maximum torque or load that can be applied to a motor running at a given stepping rate without losing synchronism. Then pull-in rate or speed is the maximum switching rate at which a loaded motor can start without losing a step. Then pull-out rate or speed is the switching rate at which a loaded motor will remain in synchronism as the switching rate is reduced. The slew range is the range of switching rates between pull-in and pull-out within which the motor runs in synchronism but cannot start up or reverse. So in general, a stepper motor will have high torque at low speeds but low torque at high speeds. Movement at low speeds is jerking unless the drive has micro stepping capability. So moments will be choppy at low speeds. At higher speeds, the stepper motor is not choppy, but it does not have as much torque as in case of lower speeds. When idle, a stepper motor has a higher holding torque than a servo motor of similar size, since current is continuously flowing in stepper motor windings. The advantages are that the motor has full torque at standstill, that is when windings are energized. It has excellent response to starting, stopping, reversing. Very reliable since there are no contact brushes in the motor, so which is something that we see in DC motors. It has open loop control, making the motor simpler and less costly to control. And a wide range of rotational speed by changing the frequency of input pulses can be obtained. It is an excellent open loop control device for accurate speed control or precise speed control. Can be run on either direction relatively easily, and which we saw in previous slides that on changing the fashion of energization of the coil, the direction can be changed. The disadvantage is that it has rough performance at low speeds. So it will be showing some chopping nature of movement at low speed unless you use micro stepping, and it consumes current regardless of load. It has limited sizes available, is noisy, the torque decreases with speed, and the stepper motors can stall or lose position running without a control loop. During open loop operation, they are prone to missing steps, resonance effects, and low settling time. So these are something that will be, these terms will be discussed when we talk, we'll be talking about control systems in next semester. For high performance systems, closed loop control of stepper motor is desirable, which require non-linear control design tools. Now here's the third home assignment problem. A stepper motor must rotate at 500 rpm and has 15 degree per step. Evaluate the input pulse rate required in pulses per second. Now you will all be submitting the three assignments given in these lectures. I mean this one and the previous two. So submit these three assignments by the end of this month,